This is the side topic after the endocrine system.
A blessed afternoon to everyone. My name is Renalyn Fultura.
And I'm James Fultura.
And we will discuss the given topic to us, which is hormones associated with emotions. So firstly, what are hormones?
Hormones are body chemical messengers. They are important to maintain homeostatic balance. Responsible for regulating all kinds of metabolic, they also permit our brain and mediating our behavior and even the kind of thought we have. They also and even the kind of thoughts we have. They frequently view as the main drivers of our behavior, making us less to their effect. During puberty.
So now, what produces hormones and how does it work? So it is stated here that hormones exist because of the endocrine system. It is the system that makes hormones flow into our body, not only performs other physical bodily functions, but also helps to feel. So to put this more comprehensively, our body has what we call an endocrine system. And an endocrine system has glands. And these glands produce hormones. Now, according to Harvard Medical School, once these hormones release by glands into our bloodstream, bloodstream is where our blood flows. They act on various organs and tissue to control everything from the way our body functions and to even how the way our body feels. Now, what is the connection of hormone and emotions? Hormonal changes are also associated with fluctuation and moods or emotions. Hormones have the ability to affect and influence the production of certain chemicals inside our body. So in short, endocrine system has glands. Glands produces hormones. Hormones have the ability to affect and influence the chemicals. And these certain chemicals are necessary in creating emotions.
Motivates us to take action or to achieve our goal and desire. Serotonin, responsible for boosting our mood and provides us feeling of being in a cloud nine or euphoria. Endorphins help us alleviate anxiety and depression.
Oxytocin, or also known as love hormone, its main function is to facilitate childbirth. That's why it was called love drug or love hormone. Our bodies produce oxytocin whenever we are feeling excited towards our sexual partners or when we fall in love. So the chemical that is responsible for fear is called norepinephrine. Having a low norepinephrine can decrease the levels of an alertness of an individual or can cause a difficulty in concentrating This particular chemical is best known for its role, which is the flight or fight response. Next is the chemical that is responsible for anger is the epinephrine. Epinephrine is released by adrenal glands into our body whenever an individual feels anger or whenever the individual is under the state of any other form of stress. The chemical that is responsible for surprise is noradrenaline. Noradrenaline releases powerful signals that have the ability to flood our brain, and according to past research, it is also involved whenever an individual feels excited.
Thank you. advantage and disadvantage. Hormones help our body to function and feel an emotion and express ourselves. However, emotion can be scary. Whenever we feel an excessive emotion or feelings, we tend to lose control of ourselves. Our behavior, our manner. We subconsciously make promises that we didn't, and say words that we didn't mean to. That is why it is important that we must practice emotional intelligence to strengthen our emotional health.
Now let's move on to the example, food. How the food we eat affects our brain and mood. So, for example, is sugar. Consuming a large amount of sugar, such as chocolate, ice cream, or candy, can affect our chemicals, such as dopamine. And we all know that dopamine is responsible for feeling pleasure and happiness, right? So the brain uses it as a reward system in order to reinforce a certain behavior towards something. Now let's move on to trivia. So this here is called the wheel of emotion. Did you know that during the 1970s, a psychologist that came from Washington, D.C. named Paul Ekman discovered the basic type of emotions, and which he later believes that were all universally used in all human creatures. He later then decided to expand his list of emotions, and he found the wheel of emotions, which can be classified into three parts: the primary, secondary, and tertiary. How does he able to create emotions? Firstly, by combining the basic type of emotion, he was able to create the secondary emotion. By combining the secondary emotion, he was able to create the tertiary emotion. Now, another example is the quote here. Emotion play out in the theater of the body. Feelings play out in the theater of mind. The emotions and feelings are two different things. Emotion can be physically observed through physical reaction. We can easily determine if someone is overwhelmed, if someone is happy, or someone is sad. And it's because the emotion plays out in the theater of the body. While on the flip side, feelings play out in the theater of mind. Feelings can be hidden and it's also associated with mental capacity. So, for instance, if you have a crush on someone, but then you decided to keep it new to yourself. So that means that only you know what are you feeling towards that someone. So that is the examples of feelings. Once again, I'm Renalyn Futura. And we all hope that everyone has obtained a new knowledge today. Thank you.